So let's go to apple.com. And you'll notice that they have, of course, they're advertising the iPhone. That's their biggest product. So the MacBook Pro, I love my MacBook Pro, but there is a little downside to them. So if we click learn more here, these are the M4 presented by Church Tech U. It's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, which of the M4 Macs is right for ProPresenter? Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach y'all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if you're as excited about the new Macs that were announced at the end of October, as excited as I am, go ahead, like, subscribe, and tell me which one is really tempting you. And if you stick around to the end, I'll tell you which one I bought. Just FYI. Okay, so let's head over to my computer and we'll talk about which of the M4 Macs I would recommend as of the end of 2024. So here we are in ProPresenter, and that's not going to be all that helpful for you. So let's bring up a web browser, shall we? So go over here into Chrome and a new one. Of course, that goes over on the wrong screen. Funny stuff there. Okay, so let's go to apple.com. And you'll notice that they have, of course, they're advertising the iPhone. That's their biggest product. So the MacBook Pro, I love my MacBook Pro, but there is a little downside to them. So if we click learn more here, these are the M4 MacBook Pros. So if we take a closer look here, we'll go down. Let me keep expanding here. Let's actually just click on tech specs. That might take me to where I want. Okay, so we've got the 14-inch and the 16-inch. First thing I want you to notice is we've got a 10-core M4, a 12, a 14, etc. So we've got the regular M4, the M4 Pro, the M4 Pro with 14 cores, and the M4 Max. So what is important to know about those is that, first off, you can get starting at 16 gigs, so there are no MacBook Pros that are 8 gigs anymore. They're all at least 16, which is exactly what I would recommend. So bare minimum 16 gigs of RAM for that. But notice we can go up to 128 if you get the big one. So we've got that. 512, a little on the shy side, but not the worst thing ever. Personally, I'd get at least a terabyte, but 512 works if you use external storage. So that's good. So we're good here. Now, display support. This is where the big news is. Simultaneously supports full native resolution on the built-in display and up to two external displays, up to, etc., or one external display at 8K. So normally with ProPresenter, you are not going to be sending 6K. You're not even going to be sending 4K. Unless you have a super large screen and people are very close to it, they will not be able to see, even if they have perfect vision, they will not be able to see the difference between 1080p and 4K. Unless maybe they're on the first row and you've got a very large screen, but that's kind of going to be the limitation. So chances are you're going to be sending two 1080p signals, one for the congregation and one for the stage screen. So the M4 or the M4 Pro would absolutely work. Now, the only downside of these is if we go down a little bit farther. Okay, let's see here. Let's click on pre-order here because they haven't shipped yet. And when we do that, the only downside is it's $1,500 entry. So, and like I said, personally, I would update that storage. So that's going to bump that up. So keep that in mind. Very portable. Good choice if you're in a portable church. But it's like $1,500. So that's our first choice. Let's go to the second choice here. So, oh wait, it's still on MacBook Pro. Let's go back here. If you are in a situation where you're in a permanent location, oops, I've got too many tabs open on my old MacBook Pro here, so let's go down here and let's click on iMac. Now this one also has a gotcha, so this is important for you to know that if you wanted an iMac, let's say you're in a place where you're not moving things in and out very often and you want the larger screen, then maybe an iMac is the right choice for you. Let's click on tech specs here. Do you like these videos but you'd really like to learn from me in person? Well, I've got some great news for you. I am traveling around the country and maybe even around the world training churches on how to use ProPresenter. So I've got either a 1 or a 1.5 day class that you can attend. For more details, head on over to TDM.fyi/events24, the top one right here, and register for the event nearest you. If there is no event that's near you, no problem, you can request one. So head on over to TDM.fyi/class request. That's this one down here, and you can say, hey, I'm interested in attending a class, or even I'm interested in hosting a class. Up to you which you prefer. In the last one, that is just information. It's not obligation, so don't hesitate to put your information in there, and I'll let you know when there's a class in your area, or we'll talk about what it takes to host a class. It's probably a lot less than you imagine that it is. So head over there, and I look forward to meeting you in person. And when we click on tech specs, this $1,299 one might be tempting to you, but let me tell you one of the downsides is the 8-core CPU only does two screens total. Two. So that may not be a big deal if you have some external Blackmagic hardware, but I would probably steer clear of that one. I would go for the M4 with the 10 core because that can do three screens total, so the built-in screen and then one for your congregation and one for your stage. And then if you need to add other ones, you can do a DeckLink Duo or an Ultra Studio 3G monitor adapter, something like that. So, but that's probably the one that I'm going to recommend. First off, 256, still a little shy. So I'd probably do at least 512. The advantage of the desktop is you can add an external drive fairly easily. You're not like Velcroing it onto the back of a MacBook Pro, which I've totally done before. So, but I would probably upgrade to at least 512. Personally, I had a MacBook Pro that had 512, and that sucker filled up really fast. So I would probably go to a terabyte. So that's what I would do. Ideally, I always tell people, if you have more money in the budget, upgrade the RAM. You can always throw in an external hard drive above the 512. I really think 256 is too small if you're doing any media whatsoever. So keep that in mind, and then that would be good to go. But the downside of that one is, if we click on that for pre-order, remember this is the one that we're dealing with. So we're looking at $1,400, but with less storage than I would normally recommend. So you would probably want to update that, and I think that's $200 extra. So that's probably what I would do. So if you wanted to go with an iMac, I would ignore this guy and go for this one right here. But there is another Mac that they have announced, and this is the one that I'm actually buying, and that is the new Mac Mini. Now notice all of them come with the 10 core. That's how you can tell how many screens it supports, by the way. Now, it used to be, if there was a word after the number, that told you how many screens it would support. But now, if it's 10 core or more, it will support at least 3 screens. Now, if it's an iMac or a MacBook Pro, that includes the built-in screen, so do keep that in mind. But for the Mini, there's no built-in screen. So the Mini can do 3 screens. Now, why haven't I bought a Mac Mini before now? Well, as it turns out, I really wanted one, but I wanted the 3 screens. I'm now used to 3 screens. Granted, I've got the other hardware from a ProPresenter standpoint, so I would have been fine on ProPresenter, but for everything else, I wanted 3 screens. So I actually ordered this one, but I upgraded a couple of things. So let's select this, and I will show you what I ordered for myself. I upped the RAM because, like I said, you can't update the RAM, so I might as well pay the extra $200. And I think the 512 is not 256, not enough. 512, it's on the edge of not enough. For myself personally, I added a terabyte. So this is the machine that I bought right there, and it was $1,200, which I recognize is about double of, maybe, I can't remember if it was $1,199 or $1,299. I want to say $1,299. So I recognize that that's just shy of double of the entry level one. But every penny that you put into a computer when you buy it could potentially save you time on the back end. So the machine that we were just looking at was a 2019 MacBook Pro that I bought back in early 2020. So that, by overbuying back then, I haven't run into too many issues now, coming up on 5 years later. So that's why I initially was just going to buy the 16 gigs of RAM, but I thought, look, if I spend the extra 200, then that's probably going to get me at least 6 months or a year extra out of this machine. So that's why I went ahead and I went with that. The terabyte storage, I've got external drives, but it's really nice to have a whole terabyte internal to your machine. So that's why I did that. Now, if you are in a situation where you are a portable church, and if you don't want to spend the money for a MacBook Pro, what you could do is you could get a small Pelican case, or there are cheaper versions from Harbor Freight and other online retailers that you can get that would be about laptop size. Put a screen like this one in. This is actually a portable screen. And then just hook up all your cables, shut it down when you're done, have an external keyboard and mouse or trackpad, and you're good to go. So right now, I'm considering, as I do the in-person training, I always take this keyboard and this trackpad anyway. I also always take my iPad, so should I take this screen? And then I've got a two-screen setup with a Mac Mini? Maybe. I'm considering it. Or maybe I'll continue to take my MacBook Pro, but cut down on the amount of stuff that's on it, rebuild it from scratch, you know, just erase it completely, start fresh, and then see if I don't have good success there. So those are the two things that I'm considering. And because the Mac Mini is so much smaller than the previous Mac Mini, I can just throw that in my backpack along with my iPad. And there are ways to do it built in, but I'm having mixed success on that. So I might need to get some additional hardware, or I might need to get some additional software so that it would fire up as an external display, but that's something that I could do. So just to keep that in mind, if it were up to me, I'm probably going to recommend this to my church, is update to the M4 Mac Mini, get more storage, maybe more RAM, and you'll have a great machine for ProPresenter. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter Quick Start course. So head on over to tdm.fyi/proquick. Give me your name and email address, and I'll make a login for it for you for free. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.